Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 23rd of November. India's Supreme Court demands status report as COVID-19 tally crosses 9.1 million. Pakistan's opposition alliance PDM seeks end to Imran Khan's puppet rule. And Prime Minister Oli Woo's opposition amid rift within Nepal Communist Party. And now for all the details. India's Supreme Court on Monday asked the centre and states to file status reports detailing steps taken to deal with the COVID-19 situation as the country's cases tally has crossed the 9.1 million mark. Meanwhile, authorities have allowed educational institutes to reopen in a phased manner where the COVID-19 situation is slightly better.
As India's COVID-19 tally crossed the 9.1 million mark on Monday, the country's Supreme Court asked the centre and states to file status reports detailing steps taken to deal with the current situation. The apex court also noted that the pandemic has worsened in places like capital New Delhi and western Gujarat state, and that all efforts shall be made to mitigate the situation. Meanwhile, in parts of India where the COVID situation is slightly better, universities, colleges and schools have been allowed yet again to reopen in a phased manner to avoid overcrowding at campuses. Educational institutes in India were closed in March following the nationwide lockdown to curb the COVID-19 spread.
और उसके बाद पूरा स्कूल सैनिटाइज किया है जो क्लास में इनके क्लासेस होंगे वहाँ हमने बेंच के ऊपर स्टूडेंट का नाम लिखा है सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग कितना करना है वो भी हमने किया है.
Despite witnessing a sudden surge in virus cases, India's recovery rate as of Friday was recorded 93.68%, while fatality rate stood at 1.46%.
Residents of the Indian capital, New Delhi, expressed relief over getting some respite from the toxic smog as weather seemed to have improved drastically on Monday. However, the air quality index continued to hover over 200, which is considered poor and unhealthy.
Residents of Indian capital New Delhi have expressed they are little relieved as they have got some respite from the toxic smog. However, the air quality on Monday was recorded at 219, which is considered unhealthy. The smog was comparatively less on Monday and visibility also improved. People who were out early in the day said they were feeling the air was better as opposed to last week when the country celebrated Diwali, the Hindu festival of lights, which also witnesses revelers bursting firecrackers.
Diwali se pehle kafi zyada tha, kafi logo ke eyes mein jalan, stomach jisme saans lene mein dikkat, choking wagaira ye sab tha, bahar nikalne mein bachcho ko bhi dikkat thi, bado ko bhi, lekin ab kafi fark hai. दिवाली के बाद से बारिश हुई है उसके बाद से पोल्यूशन काफी कम हो गया और अब तो मॉर्निंग वॉक वगैरह सब चीजों में बहुत आराम है.
न्यू दिल्लीज एयर पोल्यूशन टिपिकली वर्सन्स इन अक्टूबर एंड नवंबर ड्यू टू फार्मर्स बर्निंग एग्रीकल्चर वेस्ट कोल फायर्ड पावर प्लांट्स ट्रैफिक एंड विंडलेस डेज.
इन न्यूज फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान, द पाकिस्तान डेमोक्रेटिक मूवमेंट हेल्ड इट्स फोर्थ पावर शो इन पेशावर ऑन संडे डिस्पाइट बीइंग रिफ्यूज्ड परमिशन ड्यू टू पेंडेमिक. In a renewed attack on Prime Minister Imran Khan's government, the leaders sought an end to the puppet rule, warning that actions and policies of the government based on a stolen mandate were akin to hollowing out the country.
The Pakistan Democratic Movement leaders on Sunday, in a renewed attack on Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government, sought an end to the puppet rule, warning that actions and policies of the government based on a stolen mandate were akin to hollowing out the country. Alleging rigging in 2018 general elections of Pakistan, Jamiat Ulema-e-Islam Fazal chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman tore into Imran Khan government and the army, saying the rulers should now be shamed and sent home.
Aur aaj bhi hum aapko mohlat dete hain, aap unke pushtibani se piche hat jaye, dastbardar ho jaye, aur aap keh de ki ye hamari hukumat nahi hai, aap is hukumat ke khilaf आवाज हमारे साथ मिलाए, फिर हम और आप भाई भाई हैं, आप सियासत में क्यों आते हैं?
During the rally, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari delivered a long speech to the gathering and said that despite massive rigging in the recent Gilgit-Baltistan elections, constituent parties of the BDM received the most number of votes, indicating the defeat of the PTI.
मैंने पूरा गिलगित बल्तिस्तान का दौरा करके आया हूँ, चप्पा चप्पा का दौरा करके आया हूँ, पीडीएम का मंशूर, पीडीएम का नजरिया गिलगित बल्तिस्तान के पहाड़ों तक लेकर गया था, और जहाँ के धांधली की वजह से आपको वो सीटें नहीं दिए गए, मगर इनके हटकंडे के बावजूद, इनके धांधली के बावजूद, लेवल प्लेइंग फील्ड ना होने के बावजूद सबसे ज्यादा वोट्स पीडीएम के जमाते को मिले हैं और पीटीआई को शिकस्त मिली।
Imran Khan on November 15 staked claim on the Gilgit-Baltistan government after the PTI emerged as the biggest party in the election for the region's legislative assembly.
Moving on, Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has said that Pakistan's plan to turn Gilgit-Baltistan into provisional province is an attempt to create divisions. There has been resentment across the illegally occupied territories of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan over the move that is against UN resolutions.
Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir Raja Farooq Haider Khan has termed Pakistan's plans to turn the illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan region into a provisional province as an attempt to create divisions. Speaking during an event recently, Khan expressed concern that Kashmir has been reduced from over 84,000 to nearly 5,000 square kilometers, highlighting demographic and geographical changes by Islamabad in the illegally occupied territories of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan over the years.
उधर एक तकसीम कर रहे, इधर एक तकसीम कर रहे। मैंने समझ सका सामे मौजूद से कि वे 84,000 से ना 5,000 पर आ गए। अभी मैंने आज बुलाए हुए प्रिंसिपल तरफ पढ़ ली है। मैंने जिला बारामूला की हदूद का तय करना जीबी के साथ।
There has been resentment across Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan over Islamabad's move to alter Gilgit-Baltistan's status against UN resolutions. Activists have blamed that China has a major role in lobbying Pakistan to bring Gilgit-Baltistan under its legal jurisdiction to protect its investments in the illegally occupied region, which are part of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC.
As US President Donald Trump recently announced a reduction in American troops' presence in Afghanistan in the upcoming months, Abdullah Abdullah, head of High Council for National Reconciliation, has said withdrawal of US forces from Afghanistan should be dependent on the progress in the peace efforts with the Taliban. The peace negotiations in Doha have been faced with deadlock over disagreements on the procedural rules of the talks.
Abdullah Abdullah, head of the High Council for National Reconciliation, in an interview with the Associated Press has said the withdrawal of the US forces from Afghanistan should be dependent on the progress in the peace efforts with the Taliban. US President Donald Trump announced a reduction in American troops' presence in Afghanistan in the upcoming months and had last week ordered the US Defense Department to reduce the number of American troops in Afghanistan to 2,500 by mid-January. The peace negotiations in Doha have been faced with deadlock over disagreements on the procedural rules of the talks. Amid stalled talks and rising violence, US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo was in Qatar on Saturday to discuss regional security and economic ties. The U.S. State Department, in a statement on Pompeo's trip, said Qatar has been an important partner in fostering peace in Afghanistan and has played an invaluable role as host for Afghanistan peace negotiations. Meanwhile, reports have surfaced that a breakthrough has been reported from Doha as two negotiating teams have agreed to include the U.S.-Taliban deal, UN endorsements for Afghan peace process, commitments of the negotiating teams and will of the Afghan people as the base for upcoming negotiations.
In news from Nepal, at a time when the rift within the ruling Nepal Communist Party seems to be widening, NCP co-chair and Nepal's premier KP Sharma Oli met the main opposition party leader Sher Bahadur Deoba, reports have suggested. There are speculations that Oli might choose to part ways with his co-party chair Pushpa Kamal Dahal, and in such a situation, he will need support of Nepali Congress to remain in power.
Amid rising conflict between ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP chairs KP Sharma Oli, also the Prime Minister, and Pushpa Kamal Dahal, Oli over the past weekend held an hours-long meeting with the leader of the main opposition Nepali Congress, Sher Bahadur Deoba, local media reports said on Monday. Reports suggested the meeting revolved around appointments to constitutional bodies, but it also touched upon some possible power equations if Oli's Nepal Communist Party split. Dahal and his faction has called the move a bluff. This comes at a time when there are rumours that Oli might choose to part ways with Dahal. In such a situation, Oli will need support of Nepali Congress to remain in power. The Nepal Communist Party has 173 seats in the 275-member parliament, but lawmakers are divided mainly along three factions, led by Oli, Dahal and Madhav Kumar Nepal. If NCP splits, the Congress party becomes a decisive force, as it currently has 60 seats.
With an aim to highlight Tibet's issues with China, a bike rally was organized by the Tibetan Youth Congress, an NGO. Started from Macleod Ganj in India's northern Himachal Pradesh state, the rally came to a close on Sunday after it reached all the way to China border in Kinnaur.
Exiled Tibetans in India reached Himalayan tourist hub of Shimla on Sunday, leading their bike rally to spread awareness about Chinese aggression. Organized by Tibetan Youth Congress, an NGO, the rally started from Macleod Ganj in Himachal Pradesh state and went all the way to China border in Kinnaur. The bike rally was undertaken with a purpose to spread awareness about Chinese intrusions into its neighbors' borders, building pressure to release political prisoners in Tibetan Autonomous Region, and a campaign to boycott Chinese goods.
Every time we lobby, we reach out to the elected members, representatives in the in government, but we thought that this would be a very good chance for the team and for myself to meet the Delhi people and talk to them, let them know while you're having chai, you know, what is Tibet, what is Tibet issue and what is Indo-Tibet border.
China seized control over Tibet in 1950 in what it described as a peaceful liberation that helped it throw off its feudalistic past. But critics led by exiled spiritual leader the Dalai Lama say Beijing's rule amounts to cultural genocide.
Women in far-flung areas of India's Jammu and Kashmir are being imparted handicraft skills, including embroidery, tailoring and stitching, as part of government's special skill development programs. The beneficiaries have expressed they now feel empowered and feel a sense of financial independence.
In a bid to empower women of far-flung areas in India's Jammu and Kashmir, various handicraft skills are being imparted through government-sponsored schemes like Pradhan Mantri Mahila Shakti Yojana. Women are being encouraged to learn abilities such as embroidery, tailoring and stitching through such government special scheme development programs.
दूर-दूर से लड़कियां आती हैं, तो इनको हम इसलिए काम सिखाते हैं कि ये अपने पैरों पर स्टैंड हो सकें, क्योंकि आजकल तो आपको पता है कि लड़कियां हर काम में आगे ही जाती हैं, तो इसलिए हम इनको ये ट्रेनिंग वगैरह देते हैं और लोन भी देते हैं, इनकी सोसाइटियां भी चलाते हैं, तो ताकि ये लड़कियां अपने पैरों पर स्टैंड हो सकें, किसी की मोहताज ना हो।
किसी के आगे मैं हाथ नहीं फैलाऊंगी, आप मैं ये काम कर सकती हूँ, करूँगी, अपना रोजी रोटी खुद मैं इंतजाम कर लूँगी, आप इसका कोई टेंशन नहीं।
schemes like the Mahila Shakti Kendra aim at enabling women to avail entitlements from the government and facilitating their training and capacity building. The centers are meant to provide opportunities to women in skill development, employment, health and nutrition.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.